Hello, welcome. Sean Roberts, Chief Technologist for Lincoln Network, and this is Lincoln Shorts. I have with me Matt Dunlop, the Secretary of State for the state of Maine. I said that kind of backwards. Maine's Secretary of State maybe is a better, less wordy way of putting it. Matt, is that okay to call you by your first name? Matt,
yeah.
So be informal. We've been asking a couple of different elections officials, and I hope to get more before the election, about each state's perspective on different issues that or situations that voters might find themselves in. One of them would be, what should a voter do if somebody asks for your ballot? Meaning either at the polling place or a voting center, maybe you guys don't have voting centers there, or at your door.
Well, okay. So in Maine, we don't have voting centers. We have our elections run at the town level. So we have 503 municipalities that are responsible for the administration of local, county, state, and federal elections. Our job in the Secretary of State's office is to support the town. So we print all the ballots. We do training. We provide equipment like tabulating machines. We maintain the central voter registration system, which, you know, while you fill out a paper registration card, it is scanned into the system. And that's the only thing we have that really faces the internet. We can talk about vulnerabilities later, but if somebody asks for your ballot, like say they're canvassing door to door and say, oh, have you marked your absentee ballot? I can take it for you. They shouldn't. Under Maine law, you can designate a third party, including a family member, you know, spouse, whatever, a friend, to go down to the town hall and get your absentee ballot for you and return it, but you designate them on the application. So, and this is something that's come up as a question recently because of the pandemic and the urgency around protecting people, we've been turning to the absentee ballot as a tool. And in the presidential cycle of 2016, I think we issued something like 250,000 absentee ballots. We have 3.5 weeks to go, and we're already at over 340,000 so far. So people are using absentee ballots at a much greater pace than they ever have before, including people who've never used them before. So to help them return their absentee ballot to the town clerk, and it has to be in possession, the possession of the clerk by 8 p.m. on election night. We don't have a postmark deadline, for example. The governor has helped us out using the procurement capacity. We've been getting absentee ballot drop boxes for the towns. And
right. The
questions come up, can, you know, people just take your ballot and drop it off for you? Well, you know, we have no way to police that. But like I said, the law says you have to designate someone to handle your ballot for you. You know, if you would trust somebody with your lawnmower and they'll say, hey, I'm going down to the drop box, I'll take your ballot with me and I'll drop that one off too, and you trust them, then we have no way to stop them. But
right.
then you had the circumstance in North Carolina a couple of years ago where someone was harvesting absentee ballots
and
doing bad things with them. So if somebody asks you for your ballot, you should be very suspicious.
Understood. This has come up in a couple of different localities around the country of where the drop boxes are. Some states have laws on the books where the only drop box in each county can be, has to be monitored and it has to be at the elections office. Is that the same case in your state?
Well, we've never used them before. And this is all very new to us, but you know, we've had some discussions with advocates about, you know, like say having them on college campuses, for example, because like you have the University of Maine, which is sort of self-contained. It's not like, you know, other New England schools that are in, like Boston has like 60 colleges and they're part of the city fabric. Well, that's not the case at the University of Maine. It's a campus unto itself. And if you don't want the students to be leaving campus and going into town, shouldn't you have a drop box? Well, the problem with that is, you know, we've already heard of this happening since we're using drop boxes for the first time, that, you know, people are putting ballots in drop boxes in towns not their own. So we are taking the drop boxes and we're putting them on city hall property, not next to the post office, because you know what winds up in those drop boxes? People's bills and birthday cards. and we've also had reports that people are just putting loose ballots in the drop boxes. They're not putting the absentee ballot envelope, which is steel old, you know, so there's not much you can do with those. But, you know, take the university again. I'll pick on that for a minute because I live right near the University of Maine. If you had a Dropbox at the University of Maine, say by public safety, secure location, well, you have students who live off campus. They may live in the town of Orono. They may live in the city of Old Town. They might live in the city of Bangor, the town of Milford. Mm-hmm. And they see the Dropbox. They put their ballot in there. Well, it's going to go to Orono. It's not going to, you know, may not be returned to their specific town in time for it to be counted because it has to be in possession of the clerk by 8 p.m. So, you know, this is new technology for us. And we've been putting the word out there for people, you know, to take that extra 5 minutes, make sure they sign the envelope, make sure they're putting it in their town's Dropbox. So, you know, I think we'll see this be developed more robustly in the out years, but this is the first time we've used it, this technology. And so right now, because every town manages election, if a town chooses to have a Dropbox, we are recommending they keep it on at town hall. So.
Well, thank you very much for that. This has been Lincoln Shorts. Yeah.